Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know about how the coronal particles, I'm talking about the rest coronal phase, has charge of it, depending on basically the charge of this dispersed medium. So that can be, that is the coronal particle that could acquire a positive charge also, or that could acquire a negative charge also. So depending on that thing, we are going to talk about electrophoresis. So what is electrophoresis and what is the phenomenon behind that and what are the application of that? Let us talk about this in this lecture. So talking about electrophoresis, let us understand the definition of it first. So the definition of the electrophoresis is as follows, that is, the migration of the colloidal particles to the electrodes of opposite charge under the influence of an electric field is called as electrophoresis. So this is the definition of the electrophoresis, but let me talk about the phenomenon. So how does this phenomenon arise? Suppose if we have two electrodes, and the two electrodes in which basically one is basically the one which consists of negative charge electrode and the one which is basically positive charge. So talking about the colloidal particles, that is, if I am talking about the colloidal phase as well as colloidal medium, so that could acquire a positive charge also as well as negative charge also. But talking about the colloidal phase, and that is the dispersed phase as well as the dispersed medium. So the dispersed phase, suppose if it has positive charge, then the dispersed medium will have a negative charge on it. So therefore the magnitude of the charge will remain same, only the sign will be the different. So in this case, basically, I am introducing, suppose, two electrodes, and that two electrodes, one which basically the one which is the negative charge electrode and the one which is positive charge electrode. So suppose if the colloidal particle, or especially I am talking about the dispersed phase, if that is positive, so that will move towards the electrode which is of opposite charge, that is, it will move towards the negative electrode. And if it is, that is the colloidal particle, that is, if I am talking about the dispersed phase, if that is basically negative, then it will move towards the electrode which is of opposite charge, that is, positive charge electrode. So this kind of movement, or this kind of migration of the charged colloidal particle towards its opposite charged that is electrode, this kind of migration is known as electrophoresis, and this can be possible in presence of that is electric field. So this is what I want to talk about, and this is the phenomenon that arises whenever an electric field is being supplied in a colloidal solution. So for that, let me give an example for this, so that we could understand it in a very better way. So let us talk about that one. Suppose this is a U-tube that I have just drawn over here, and that consists of basically two electrodes, and these two electrodes are platinum electrodes, but I have mentioned it in the green one and red one, so as to differentiate that one is basically a negative electrode and the one is basically positive platinum electrodes. So this is a cap which covers both of the electrodes, and meanwhile in this tube we see there is a colloidal solution, and that colloidal solution is, suppose this is of the value where, and suppose that colloidal solution has a volume of this one, which I could represent over in this way. So this part is basically the colloidal that is the solution, and over which I have insert, I could add water. So even here the presence of water is there, so I am just mentioning over here as water, while this one and this one, the both are electrodes, I would refer as platinum electrode, because platinum electrode is an inert electrode, and basically here we could see that there are particles of that is colloidal solution, and here I have inserted, or if I have added it here as water, so that water level should be of in the both the sides, it will be same, as well as we could see the that is volume occupied or the level of the colloidal solution is also the same over here. So here I am applying the high voltage current over here, so that if I pass the electricity through this, so this one will acquire positive charge while this one will acquire negative charge. But meanwhile, we have understood that colloidal particles, that is, if I am especially talking about the colloidal phase, or that is the dispersed phase, so that colloidal particle consists of, can be positive also, can be negative also. So suppose if that consists of a negative charge, so this is the colloidal particle that I am talking about. So there are multiple colloidal particles that would be there. So just for an instance, I am representing it in this way. So if I am saying that if the colloidal particle is negative in charge, so obviously they will move towards the electrode which is of opposite charge or which is of positive charge. So that is the reason, since this is what we have mentioned over here as a positive charge. So therefore, every colloidal particle which is of negative charge, it will move towards the electrode. And this is nothing known as the migration of the colloidal particles or migration of the charged colloidal particles. And this will move to a respective electrode of opposite charge. So therefore, they all will move in such a manner that they all will try to deposit. Basically, and now you could see that the water, since here the water was being present on both the sides. So now what happens is, now the water level, it gets down, and basically the level of here of, so now what happens is the level of water over here, it decreases, and but meanwhile the level of the colloidal solution here, it increases, and here still the water value, it goes on increasing. So therefore we could say that most of the colloidal particles, they would get attached on this one, on this electrode, and meanwhile you could say that the water level, which was basically of this much, will now be decreased till suppose this much, suppose, because suppose if this also have been entered over here, so we could see that there is a rise, or there, but meanwhile there is a rise in the colloidal solution over here. So this indicates what? This indicates that obviously we could see that the level of this colloidal solution, it goes on decreasing, while here it goes on increasing. So meanwhile we could say that the charged particles has moved from a level to its opposite charge electrode. So this is the electrophoresis that I was talking about, and so this was the phenomenon behind this one. So it's a very very simple concept, and talking about the positive charge, suppose this is what I have talked about, the electrodes which were of negative charge. This were the colloidal particles which were of the negative charge, as I have mentioned over here. But what if the colloidal particles are positive charge? So if the colloidal particles are of positive charge, then obviously we could say that all those will be migrated towards the negative electrode, that is this electrode. And here the level of the colloidal solution will go on decreasing, and meanwhile here the water level will go on increasing. So this kind of thing, it happens. And we are using the water because just as to analyze that how the migration would have taken place over here. So this is what it is clear right now. So now let us move on to the application. So what are the application behind this? Even this is the main topic that I want to talk about. So the applications of this electrophoresis are as follows. That is, we could determine, while doing this process, we could easily determine that the colloidal particles that have been present in the colloidal solution, I'm talking about the dispersed phase. So are they positive or are they negative? That could be determined by this method. And I mentioned about this thing earlier. And talking about the second application, so we could also determine the rate of the electrophoresis, or and what is the migration rate of which where we could see a particular colloid is being transferring to its respective electrodes at in what amount of time. So that is also, we could determine the rate of the electrophoresis. So that is the second application. Talking about the third one, so now talking about the application number three. Suppose if multiple that is colloidal particles of different charge or of different size are being present over here. So even we can separate that kind of colloidal particles by doing this kind of electrophoresis, because suppose if I am talking about protein or a kind of colloidal particles that are being present of different sizes, so even that could be easily, because depending on the charge on the with the help of that is electrophoresis, so even that could be done. So there are various applications. So this were the few applications that I was talking about here. So that's it, friends. It was a very easy concept to understand, because the colloidal particles also have charge already. So that is the reason that multiple applications could be done in this kind of method. So thank you, friends, for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you'll share this with your friends. So till then, don't forget to subscribe to EKIDA channel. Thank you so much.